Roman Empire. Have you heard of her?
No.
You never stop learning. Tarquin entered her room, sword drawn, and told her that if she didn't give in to his desires, he would kill her. Then, he'd kill a slave boy, and he'd place her dead, naked body next to the body of the slave boy, making it look as if she'd been caught in the act of adultery.
What happened next?
Well, rather than leave behind a legacy of dishonor, Lucretia relented. Tarquin raped her and snuck away. But in order to prove that only her body and not her chastity had been taken advantage of, she took her own life.
How do you know all this?
I've always loved crime stories.
Okay, I have some bad news.
You're dying.
No, not that bad.
I'm dying.
No, my parents are in town and they're visiting and they're coming around.
I've got parents. American parents.
Yeah.
When?
Now. They told me and I didn't tell you because I thought they'd cancel and they didn't.
Now.
So you should probably put on some pants.
Oh God, okay. Do they know I exist?
I mentioned something like you, but nothing very specific, so... and they're quite conservative, so maybe not those pants. Oh God, okay.
Could you just store them? Store them.
Come on up!
What?
I'm sorry, they don't like waiting.
Okay, do I live here?
Definitely not.
Okay, are we having sex?
Yes, but not oral.
I wasn't gonna mention oral.
Okay, well don't.
How do you think it was gonna come up?
Well, I don't know. If it does, just deny it.
Who's gonna bring it up? Your dad, Tim, had any cuddling with my daughter recently?
Well, you never know. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Hello, Dad! Mom, hi, this is Tim.
Hello, sir, ma'am.
Tim actually lives here.
Yes. Yeah, but no oral sex, I promise you.
I beg your pardon?
We can drink to Sybil's safe return.
Why not? I'll bring for a glass.
Oh, never mind that. Here.
You're not very fastidious about doing things properly, are you?
Are you?
Less than you might think.
Are you at all political?
Yes, but with a hung parliament, it's hard to get excited about a by-election. You know, nothing will change, no matter who gets in. Thank you for coming to Sybil's rescue. You're very brave. She told me you knocked a man down.
I hope I did my duty.
Are you a creature of duty?
Not entirely.
When you flirt with me, or laugh with me, is that a duty? Are you conforming to the fitness of things, doing what's expected?
Don't play games. I don't deserve it. Not from you.
Well, you should be careful not to break Sybil's heart. I think she has a crush on you.
Well, I'm sure that's nothing anyone could accuse you of.
Oh, I don't know.
I assume you speak in the spirit of mockery.
You should have more faith.
May I remind you of some of the choicest remarks you made when I first arrived here? Because they live as fresh in my mind as the day you spoke them.
Matthew, what am I always telling you? You must pay no attention to the things that I say.
Can I come in?
Why?
She might get cold. Very nice.
What?
Your flat. It's very pleasant.
I'm not coming into work because I need to stay here. I need to stay here in case there's news. And actually, if you had any form of understanding or humanity or simple feeling or frankly, if you weren't suffering from some kind of Asperger's, then you would know that the last thing that I need right now is your bullying little phone calls asking me to come into work so that you can update me on fish. You want to fill me in on fishing? Well, Dr. Jones, you can take your work and you can shove it up your unfeeling ass.
I didn't come here to talk to you about work.
Then why are you here?
I made you a sandwich.
Why?
You're probably not eating, are you? No. You see, it's very important. You must eat something. Charlotte told her. Here.
I don't know what to do. I'm sorry, Dr. Jones.
Just call me Fred. You all right now?
Yeah.
You all right?
I'm sorry.
No, don't. Should I get a plate and you can put this on it?
No, I'll get a plate. I'm sorry about what I said before. That's just unforgivable.
The great thing about people with Asperger's is it's very difficult to hurt their feelings, so I don't mind really. You can say what you like.
И потом мне казалось, что вы, ну я не знаю, что вы преувеличиваете наши отношения добрых знакомых. Я не знаю, вы просто странно смотрите, вы кричите, и вы хватаете за руку. Чего это? Право, может подумать, что вы ожидаете какого-то удобного случая, который вам для чего-то нужен.
Marc n'est plus lui-même. Il devient méchant. Mais c'est parce qu'il a peur. Je comprends pas. C'est la première fois. Toute sa vie, il a eu du courage. Un homme très résistant. J'ai aimé cet homme. Encore plus aujourd'hui.